हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल सी MRI पेल्विस फॉर फीमेल। दिस इज प्लेन एंड कॉन्ट्रास्ट स्टडी। फर्स्ट वी विल सी प्रिपरेशन फॉर MRI पेल्विस। सो हेयर इज द प्रिपरेशन विच वी रिक्वायर फॉर MRI पेल्विस प्लेन एंड कॉन्ट्रास्ट। फर्स्ट वी रिक्वायर ब्लड टेस्ट विच इज सीरम क्रिएटिनिन। सेकेंड, previous reports like sonography, CT scan or MRI or any other blood investigations. And third, most important, written consent, which is patient has to be briefly explained. Then we have to give injection buscopan to avoid bowel artifacts just before taking the patient inside. And last one, make sure the patient should pass urine just before taking her inside the MRI. So here is the protocol which we follow. First we have to take a 3-plane localizer. Position as per you, we can take patient head first or feet first depending on the patient comfortable position. Then first we have to take a 3-plane localizer. Then we have to take titivated sage first. Then according to the reference line, here I want to mention that reference line here we are taking endometrium, which is you can see here. So according to endometrium we have to take coronal and axial according to the endometrium. You have to follow the reference line here. So first we have taken 3-plane localizer, then titivated sage, titivated coronal, titivated axial, T1 weighted axial, T2FS axial, diffusion, pre-contrast T1FS, then embolic zone, this is in-phase and out-phase, then dynamic, this is very important. In dynamic you have to take this, depend on the radiologist in which plane radiologist wants dynamic. Basically sagittal or axial the dynamics are taken. Here you can see we have taken the dynamics in axial plane. You can see the dynamic phases and number of dynamics. You can take up to 8 dynamics, in which first is plane and the next 7 are dynamics, which is arterial, and the rest are venous and washout phases. After dynamics, 3 plane post contrast, which is trans, coronal and sagittal, and this gradient is optional, that is why we have kept it here a pause. Now come to the planning and how do we plan. After taking the sagittal you have to take coronal. As we have mentioned earlier that you have to take a reference line endometrium. You can see here we have kept it perpendicular to the endometrium here. See that I am scrolling it down and you can see the planning. And next is axial. You can see here the axial planning parallel to the endometrium. Planning of dynamic, you can see here the area of coverage here. In few cases where patient has large fibroid or any other lesion, in that case you can keep it straight, as our region of interest are lesion, not the endometrium. So in that case, you can keep it straight, the planning of kernel and actual. And the next, all three planes, axial, coronal and sagittal, you can keep according to your plane scan. You can see the planning of axial post contrast. So the key points are here. First, you have to give Busco pan so you can see the images clearly, and you won't get the artifact from the bowels, that is the peristalsis waves. Next, you can see the planning of post contrast coronal, and the last is planning of sagittal. That is it. If you have any doubt, please let me know. Thank you.